Okay, next on our list is the 60s. Now, I know that it's an era, sort of a funny thing to put out there, but an interesting thing about the 60s is it's a decade that we really kind of associate with people taking note, people saying, hey, what was going on? And I'm actually talking before the Vietnam War even. I'm talking about like the early 60s. The 60s are the era where the folk movement was born. And I think that the folk movement is really interesting to bring up because it's really a social and political movement as much as it is a musical movement. People we would associate with the folk movement are Pete Seeger. And a fun fact about Pete Seeger is he actually also published a magazine called Sing Out, you know? I mean, he was telling you to look around, to do things, which has kind of been our theme here. And so there's Pete Seeger, there's Bob Dylan, and a great woman to put on that list is Joan Baez. I think a fantastic, fantastic thing about this is that up until that point, kind of politically based subject matter had sometimes been infused into songs, but people hadn't really been writing their own music. Guthrie sometimes, but you know, up until that point, really, people hadn't started to write songs like and to put out albums that were really pointing to the government and pointing to the issues in America. And for the first time here, these artists, who were really artists and who could write the most beautiful melodies, were putting those together with words. And for example, a guy like Bob Dylan, he's my quintessential example of the 60s because I think what he did was so amazing. We know him very much as a singer, but Bob Dylan is, he writes the most intense lyrics and these fantastic songs. For example, the song Blowin' in the Wind, which was actually popularized by Peter, Paul, and Mary, was written by Bob Dylan, which is why I think Bob Dylan is my quintessential figure for the 60s. He wrote so many songs that like it was really hard to pick, but I think my three favorites are Blowing in the Wind, The Times They Are Changing, and the fantastically moving I Shall Be Released. I want to end this segment with a quote by Dylan from Blowing in the Wind, where he just asks a very simple question that I think we could still ask today. How many roads must a man walk down before you call him a man?